Hello everybody, welcome to another edition of Reviewing and Improving Your Store on VIP Art Digital Channel. My name is Cataline and I'm a designer for fun. In today's video, again, we're gonna have a look over one of our friend's stores and let's see what can we improve together. So without wasting time, let's start working, shall we? Okay, welcome back to my computer. As you can see, I have Redbubble open and voila, this is our friend's shop. It's called Dentalism. And it's a pretty unique name. I like it. Now, first things first, as we always do, I will be the customer and let's try to have a look over the shop, shall we? Wow, 332 designs. That's pretty cool. And he's a new artist. Ah, nice. Well, let's have a look. Oh, I really like this one. It looks really well. Let's see what is it, shall we? This metal print looks really cool. I think I could buy one. Let's save it. I do like it. Okay, let's go back. Well, so I can see also puppies, and this one is pretty neat. Pretty cute puppies as well. I do like them. This one doesn't look so well on the mat. Okay. He sleeps as dogs do when wives bake cake. Oh, I like this one. It's pretty neat. Ooh, this poster looks quite nice. I do see a lot of dental designs. That's okay. I also see two collections. Let's have a look on them. This one I like it, but doesn't look so good on the bed mat. And what's this? No. But this one, ooh, I like this one. I like it. I really like this design, but doesn't look so good on the laptop skin. This one is okay. I like the design a lot, but I don't like the edges. This sticker looks pretty nice. Perfect. Okay. Now we finish with the reviewing as being a customer. The shop has amazing designs and I do like them. But now let's have a look, shall we? As we can see, the designer just joined in last month and they already has 332 unique designs. And when I say unique, they are pretty unique. Like, I did spend a lot of time on Redbubble and I can tell you that this type of dental designs that the shop has, like this type, these things, they are pretty unique. And seriously, I never saw something like this within the store, so I'm really impressed. And what I like about these dental designs is that it's kind of photography that is transformed with watermarks and also provides a blurryish effect that is right now trending. Again, I will make a video separately about designs that are trending in 2021, and I can give you just a quick hint: these type of designs, they do trend. And I do like the way they look like. As I said, they are pretty unique. They look like drawing illustrations together combined with watermarks. Awesome. I do like the quotes as well. But now let's examine the store a little deeper. Now, from the examination of the store, and let's click explore design to have a better seeing. We have a lot, we have some watermark designs that is really cool. We have the dentals. As you can see, there are quite a lot of dental designs, and that is amazing. Well, quite a lot of, and that is really good. Why? Because that is what your name of the store actually represent, and that is awesome. But on the other hand, let's go back to the store. Your banner is amazing. Your logo match perfectly with your banner. But when I come to the store, there is something missing. You do have two collections, and by the way, that is really good because you try to organize some of your designs, especially the dogs, within those two collections. But on the other hand, I want to see the dental collection. There is no dental collection whatsoever. And that makes me feel sad because you do have those amazing designs. Organize them, put them together. It will take you probably 1 or 2 minutes to do so. The same time, the same design, you can apply it as a feature collection as well. Why? Because in this way, by having the feature collection, those dental designs will perfectly match with your logo and with your banner. That will be your main niche of your store. And as I said, your designs are pretty unique for Redbubble. This means you open the door for opportunities. Now, the question is, if you do not know how to open a feature collection, let me show you very fast. So I will open a new link. Okay, so you go to account settings. Okay, in the account setting, just go to shop settings. Under the shop settings, here you choose the collection you want to display. Now, if you ask me what is a feature collection, let me show you very fast. So I will go to view shop. And this is a feature collection that I am talking about. So in my case, I put typography memes. This is my last store from Redbubble Vlog Challenge that I have not so many designs uploaded so far. But as you can see, by having a feature collection, allow the user to easily scroll through the designs really fast. And I also chosen to display them on a specific product. Except this one, I have to modify it later on today to be displayed perfectly. Now, let's go back to the store. So now we saw how we can add a feature collection. And again, that is really good because those designs, the customers can scroll them up really fast. And also by seeing it's a feature collection, they know that specific collection is something that you highly recommend for them to buy. And again, that is a plus. Now let's try to have a deep in look. Now, as a first glance, as I said, your designs need optimization. Like you do not want this white edge around it. Now, in your case, some of the design may be really difficult to modify, especially this one, for example. As I said, I love the art. I like watercolor paintings. And especially with this dog, looks perfect. But having this edge around it will create problem on blending. So is there a way to fix this part? Well, let's try to find out. Let's look at the t-shirt as well to have a better understanding. See, these lines, on some products, they look nice, but look at the t-shirt. These things, they won't blend very well with the color of the t-shirt itself. But on the other hand, if you have, as you saw here, this product displayed on a sticker or on art print or metal art print, they will look really good whatsoever. Now, there are a few things that you can do. Number one, you can choose to display a default product for your design. And if you do not know how to do that, the fastest way, let's go here to my store. Again, manage portfolio. And under the manage portfolio, you just select the designs you want to change the default product view. And here you have the default view. Click on it and just select stickers, for example, or metal art print. So you just scroll down and choose which one you want and click set as default. Once you click, it will take up to 15 minutes to get fully optimized onto your store. So number two, what you can do is to optimize your design one by one. And again, if you have way too many designs, like in my case, as I have here, it is really painful to go through them one by one. So what can you do if you want to speed up this process? Click here, right click or roll control on a Mac, edit, open in a new tab, right click, control on a Mac, open in a new tab. And once you are doing this for all of the designs that you want to modify, just go here and scroll down and just click edit and place them around to get the results that you desire. The third thing that you can do, if you really don't like the way that design looks like on that specific product, do not just put it there for hopefully somebody will actually buy the design. It doesn't really work that way. Just click disable. Just do not show the product. Just choose and display the products that you are most satisfied with. If it doesn't look good, or if your friends and family said that doesn't look so good, then trust me, do not display it. It will be much more beneficial for you and for your customers as well. Now, another thing that you could do, let's close this because I don't want to save them. Another thing that you could do is to take your design and do some modification. Now, what I will do right now is just, for example, purposes. Okay, I do not know what editing software you are actually using, but I can show you something very fast that you can do. So I will go here and I will download your image. And by all means, careful, you haven't protected your work at all. No watermarks whatsoever. So if I want, I can just easily comb and steal your design. And voila, your design looks already amazing. All I have to do is save as, download, and blah, 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 put in download and save. As you can see, I have already the image download and I will open it in Photoshop. Okay, so now, voila, your design is now available to me to play around with. Now, the reason why I downloaded it is because I wanted to show you what can you do in order to play around with it to get better blending with your t-shirts. So, first things first, let's unlock the layer. Okay, so now we have something like this. Now let's see how will this time look on a t-shirt. So we're going to compare this blending technique with letting it normal. So I can go back, bring a t-shirt inside. That is a Redbubble. This one is directly downloaded from Redbubble itself. Okay, and let's DX. And let's try to fill in all the colors to have a better blending. Let's change the background color to white. And let's lower the size of the dog. As you can see, the blending mode is a little different. You do not have those straight lines. Here, if you want, you can let them as they are, but try experiment a little bit with the framing of your design. You don't really have to use the approach that I show you. That is just one example. You can actually create a different kind of geometrical frames for them. If you want, you can actually go to Google and let's write geometrical frames. Okay, so as you can see here, there are so many and I want to use them as an inspiration. You don't really have to draw with those things specifically, but how do you think your design will look like inside of this frame? So inside of this, maybe it will look good or not, but check this one for example. This design is not for free, but it's good to take it as a source of inspiration to create your own watermark frames for your design. And your main dog display, you can actually place it within this frame range. So you can have an intersection of these two frames, and here you can actually display your design, especially for t-shirts. And this one will generate much more higher chances of getting sales. Well, let me give you a very fast example to see what I'm talking about. So let's head over to Photoshop, the same design. Or you can create something like this. As you can see, it looks pretty good and it looks amazing. But again, do not copy this frame specifically as I done in this video, because this is for education purpose only. If you do use this frame into your print on demand design, you're gonna be struck for copyright infringement. Use them just for source of inspiration and try to create your own art based on this for your future designs. Now, if you don't want this kind of complicated process, there's no problem. We can actually do it even faster than all of this. Well, you can go to pixabay.com and you can download some free shapes from there. And I will show you some examples of free shapes that I have around here. I have so many things that even I don't know what I'm looking for. So here, let's see, heart form, geometrical globe, jungle. Do I have fingerprint? Yeah. So for example, you can try to apply something like this. Okay, let's lower the style. Okay, and you can actually take this design on the top and clip it. And you have something like this, for example. And let's try to, but in my case, I did kind of delete a lot of the original artwork. So let me hide this one a little bit and let's bring the original one. Let's scale it down. Let's bring it on the top of the fingerprint. Let's clip it. And you can have something like this. As you can see, the blending is amazing and is really fast, much more faster than the previous way. The reason why I want to point these things out, because I want to help everybody in the same time. If you do prefer this way, that's fine. You don't have to make no changes whatsoever. I just want to show to you different approaches that you can target for your future designs. Now, let's go back to the store itself. Let's try to dig in a little bit more. As you can see, I like to dig in and I like to help you as much as possible. So let's go back. Well, now a lot of YouTubers are saying it's better to check as a default preview optimized recommended. Well, yes and no, both of them have their advantages and disadvantages. For new stores, I highly recommend you to display a specific product that you think that your designs are look the best for. In your case, you have amazing designs and all of them, they look really good for stickers as well. If you don't want stickers and you want to set on posters in order to have a higher margin, you can do that as well. Just set all of your design on posters or throw pillows. Or hardcover journals, all of them look really good and professional. So in that way, at least you know that your store is focusing on one product specifically. Well, try to think about this way. Let's say you went inside a store, okay? And you went inside there because you saw this store is actually selling posters and you came to this store for the posters specifically. Because you really want to buy a poster with a dental theme. But when I'm coming to the store, you see that those dental designs are on throw pillows, on leggings, on hardcover journals, and so on. But also, you don't really see no posters whatsoever. So you're like, okay, I may have a look around the store and then I will leave. Because why I will leave? Not all of us, we like to interact with the shop owner. With the clerk. We don't want to go necessarily to them and ask them, hey, do you have this design available on a poster, for example? Well, it's not our nature. Some of us, we are shy to do so. So because of that, we are just entering the store. We have a quick look around. I don't see the designs that... I see designs that I like, but I don't know if they are available on posters or not, and I'm just leaving. No sales whatsoever. But by setting the entire store, for example, on posters, and then here on the banner or down to your bio, you can give them a message that all of these designs are available on a multitude of products. So please check them out. So in that way, you know that your store, for example, your entire store is set on posters, but yet you are still telling the customer, hey, be careful, these designs are also available on a multitude of products. Please check them out as well. So this is one way to do it. Well, again, it's not a must. That is based on your preferences. Now, let's try to dig in a little bit more, shall we? And let's have a look at the tags, because those are really important. We do have amazing designs on the store, but we want to have more exposure to them. So let's try to have a look. Let's pick a random one, okay? Now, well, I do like one thing that you really did here in the description, and that is amazing. You told them, the customers, that besides this specific product, you also offer another 100 unique models. And that is really cool. Because why? This makes the customer more curious into looking into your store to find those. And by having a lot of designs based on this niche specifically with a lot of common tags, we'll put your designs into similar design section. So this means only your store will be displayed here whatsoever. As you can see, I do not see no other store whatsoever. And that is a really good thing to have. Because why? Most of the people, they're targeting so many different niches that when they come here to similar design, maybe one or two designs is their own store, but then here they have random stores that are not belonging to them. So because of that, the customers can jump in from one store to another without buying nothing. But in your case, because you already promote your designs, we offer 100 unique models, then the customer can scroll down and can see other designs that are still belonging to your store. So basically you are keeping your customers inside the store, and that is a thumbs up. Great job. I'm really loving it. But now let's go over to the tags. Now here, Redbubble does recommend between putting 15 to 20 tags. Well, here you can experiment to see which one is going the best for you. I always recommend going to 15 tags in order to follow Redbubble guidelines specifically. But again, you can experiment. The only difference is try to add multi-words tags in order to rank up. Because right now, if I'm looking around here, the only thing that you rank up for is surgery. So you use surgery here, and I saw it somewhere around here as well. Probably surgery. So for this work specifically, you tag, but right now you don't put your design in no specific place. So try to find a low niche that you can put your design at. Now, regarding how to create multi-words tags out of it, that is a little tricky because I'm not really sure. And in order to give you a specific information on how the customers will actually try to find those designs on Redbubble. But on the other hand, we can use keywords.io, and here let's write dental. Let's see what keywords.io will send us. So basically, this one will pull out information from Google itself and from the United States, and let's see what kind of information will give us. So we can actually use dental care, dental center, dental touch. When you pop out this message, click no. So let's see if I go for dental touch. First, let's check if it's copyrighted. Okay, so let's write here, let's go here. Well, dental care, we blah blah blah, fine, touch dental, this is dead. So basically, dental touch you can use. Now, if I go to Redbubble, let's try to open a new tab. How many searches do you think I will have it there? As you can see, no search whatsoever. So basically, you just find yourself a low competition niche. So by having dental itself, it won't really help a lot with exposure, but by having a dental touch will help you to hit a specific low competition. But by having a multi-word tag, like in our case, a dental touch, you will be the only one in that specific niche. As you can see, nobody else is whatsoever. And then for dentists, you can have, for example, the graceful touch of a dentist. So what we have done, we have took the touch and we rank up that tag. And by the way, I did make a specific video on how you can rank up your Redbubble tags, and I'll leave a link down into the description. Please check it out, it will help you a lot ranking up your designs. So basically, shortly, this is what we need to do. Try to combine those tags, don't go with multi-word tags, try to eliminate the single word tags. Make sure for each of your tags to do the copyright and trademark research. Make sure you don't hit a delicate area. Okay, now let's go back. Now, another thing that I like, you did connect a lot of social media platforms, and I did check them out beforehand, and it is a good start. The only thing is try to keep them up to date, keep adding, because you have so many designs here, but within the social media platforms, you don't have so many. So I will give you an example. Let's open Pinterest. So on Pinterest, you do have 12 followers, and that is really good, but on the other hand, you don't have so many pins. And this is something that you really want to work with. And these pins, they are actually not so much reference towards your Redbubble store. So that is something that you need to do research online. How to promote my Redbubble store to Pinterest. There are a lot of YouTube videos. In the future, I will make also some unique approaches for Pinterest marketing. And by the way, as I said, this information will help you a lot. Now, we kind of finished for today. This was kind of a long video. As I said, your store looks amazing. Try to add one collection, especially for all of your dental art, because I do love the way they are. Try to add the feature collection, the dental art, because it will match perfectly with your logo and your banner. So make sure you display at least one default product view for all of your designs. If you, again, you want to choose stickers, go for stickers. You want to choose a print artboard, go for print artboard. Do not let it optimize recommended. Why? Because as you notice, there are still a lot of designs that are not fully optimized for every single product. Like for example, this dog on the shower curtain. You do have a lot of area on the shower curtain that is not covered by the design. The same with this one. So, and this one, as you can see, they are not optimized at all in order to sell. The chances for you to actually sell this will be pretty low, like pretty low. And that is bad. Why? Because those designs, they look really good. The last thing is try to play around with the tags. Please do check my previous video about multi-word tag ranking. It will help you up a lot to get more exposure on the market. Because right now, by using simple word tags, even though are relevant to your design, but they do not really place you in a specific niche. So because of that, you have to rely heavily on external traffic. And by the way, I'm really happy that you already started to do so. But make sure you keep posting on each of the platforms every single day, at least 2 to 3 times a day, in order to see more activity on your pins, especially on Pinterest, because you do want to bring more people in to follow you. The less graphics you have, the less chances for them to actually come and follow. So you do have a lot of designs here. There is a big plus. And basically, this is kind of it. I hope you enjoyed the video. As I said, I love the store. I love the arts. My favorite ones, as I said, are the dental ones. So I wish you good luck if you're into your Redbubble journey. In like 1.5 months from now, I will come back to your store again and I will double check it to see if you made any improvements whatsoever. So everybody, if you want to help our friends, please leave a comment down into the comment section below on how do you think our friend should do in order to improve his stores and get the best out of Redbubble. So until then, everybody have a nice day. Bye bye.